Well, the White House shakeup means that Homeland Security is now looking for a new secretary. Here to discuss, J.D. Gordon, a former Pentagon spokesman and a retired naval commander, and Rebecca Grant, a former official in the office of the Air Force of the Secretary of the Air Force Secretary, and currently with Iris Independent Research. Welcome tonight to you both.
Thank you.
Great to be here.
So, Rebecca, I want to start with you. Elaine Duke will be acting DHS secretary, and then what happens next?
Well, Homeland Security is a hugely important job. You know, the department was created after 9/11, so the Trump administration won't want to leave that position uncovered for too long. But it's a heck of a job, huge, sprawling bureaucracy, a lot of different components to it. So he'll be looking for someone who's a good manager and someone who can also tap into some of the military support aspects that go into Homeland Security.
J.D., I want to go over to you on this. General Kelly's last job in the military was that he was chief of U.S. Southern Command. So in that position, he was exposed to immigration, drug trafficking, other cross-border problems, and then, of course, he's been dealing with that now. Is this a signal from this administration of where the focus is going?
Perhaps. I just think that General Kelly was very well qualified for his role at Southcom in Miami, where he was overseeing U.S. military operations for all of Latin America. And that included a major focus on things like immigration and things like counter-narcotic operations. So very well qualified there. But he's also very well qualified to be the chief of staff at the White House. Now, I know General Kelly because we worked together about a dozen years ago at the Pentagon when he was a one-star general in charge of congressional relations for the Marines. And I know Reince Priebus also from the RNC because I had been on three presidential campaigns as a senior advisor in the last three cycles. But I don't
trouble with our ships trying to conduct their freedom of navigation operations. We're not in a very good place with China. So how else do you see us being able to put pressure on North Korea without actually using military action?
China is finding that it's not all that easy to be a world power, and it's not easy to get North Korea back in shape. I think China's pressure is still very, very important, and part of what our military forces do is make it easier for China to go ahead and try to get that more reasonable solution. Now, down the road, the Trump administration will have to face China's ambitions in the Pacific. What those J-10s did to our Navy plane was inexcusable and very, very dangerous, unprofessional. They have air bases established down on the islands around the South China Sea that they've reclaimed. So Trump will have to face that down the road. But there's no question he needs China to be part of the solution. There are some encouraging talks going on at the UN. We have to hold firm with our military power and let China do what it can do as well, because it's just unimaginable to let North Korea develop a nuclear weapon that could land on us or land on our allies.
All right. Well, lots of pressure and lots to work on in as far as trying to handle this problem and move it forward. Thank you both for your insight. We'll be right
back. Thanks, Leah.